Hi guys, Chuffy here again. A nice little video here. This is my pre-Heresy Land Raider, and yes, it's a Redeemer. I am aware, and I am aware that the Redeemer is an M35 vehicle. So it's not really a pre-Heresy vehicle, but you'll see what I'm on about in a minute. I'm not just blithering. I've got a lovely kit from Chapter Studios. I had this a while ago. Put this together. It's taken me a while to get some of the parts I needed for this. So you do see the nice little flamestorm cannon with the dragon's head on. The nice little logo. I'll probably zoom in on all this actually in a minute. I'll explain in a second. And the nice little braziers. The Mechanicus symbol and all that lot. Little brazier and all this nice little logo. Now, the reason why this is my pre-Heresy vehicle is because I've magnetised it. So these flamestorm cannons come off. I'll just magnetise them together and bring it in so you can actually see nice little salamander heads, the flamestorm cannon. So I can actually change them. There's a nice little, you can see the eye there inside them. So that's the assault cannons. And then obviously drop in turn link heavy bolter, he says. Come on, you do go in, I know you do. There you go. And then the two twin linked las cannons, which I think come out really nicely. There we go. So not completely blithering, guys. It can be a redeemer when I'm not doing pre-Heresy stuff. Say I'm in a tournament match, I can actually use a flamestorm cannon if I wanted. And this is the standard pattern of the Land Raider. What I'll do now is I'll try on the tripod to zoom in on some of the details, because this thing is absolutely packed with them. So what you got is these lovely kind of scale bits, which are very reminiscent of the kind of frag launches you get on Flamestorm. And then you can see all the kind of the flames that I've done. Just loosen this. In fact, let's take the last kind of it. Sorry about that, guys. And you can actually see some of the details here. The flames behind the logo of the Salamanders. I think that's come out really nicely. So let me zoom out a little bit, and I will, in fact, we'll do this bit here. Let's move that like that. There's lots of little details I've added to this this vehicle. So you've got like a flame inside this brazier area, and then you've got this kind of snake winding up around the fire. It's kind of like dragon sneaky type thing. That looks really nice. That came out really well if you ask me. And if I spin it round and take the last cannon out again, angle it and we'll zoom in. So then we've got the kind of the two hammers that represent the fact that salamanders are all about forging steel and making weapons and armour. Probably why they have some of the best weapons and armor around of all the chapters. So yeah, that's quite nice, nicely done. I like the like little ball of fire on it. And then on this side, another brazier, but this time not with a flame. But I don't know if you'll see it very well. Inside there's like, instead of a flame, there's coals and stuff in here. It's like the fire's burnt down and It's not out. It's still hot. So you've got to be careful. So that's all quite nicely done. And then the Salamanders logos from the brass etching. As you can see there. That I got from Forge World. Which is really nice. And then, obviously, on the top, those that know me quite well, these are Skyborn mini parts. They're just like little decoration pieces. It just makes this whole thing come together, otherwise you'd have a huge empty space. And I'm putting a lot of detail on there. I might as well carry on. And obviously the corresponding other side. Another Salamanders logo on the front there. So you're in no doubt. And obviously you have to, it's a Salamanders vehicle. I've stuck the multi-melter on the top, which is also magnetised, so if it gets a weapon destroyed or whatever, you know, it's not all bad. So it's taken me quite some time to paint because of all the extra detail, but I think that it's come out really well, and I think it's worth it to spend that extra time to do these vehicles, to really make them come out and pop and basically bling, really. So that's my Land Raider Redeemer stroke normal. It was quite simple to magnetise. In actual fact, I glued this all together as a standard Redeemer and then aftermarket, as it were. Hadn't finished painting, had barely started actually, did the base colour. Had to cut the Flamestorm cannons out and then magnetise that whole area, then build up the last cannons, which took me some time getting hold of those parts. Then put it all together and it's come, if you ask me, come out quite nicely. Like the OSL on the front here, not too overpowering. All the lenses on the thing's been glossed up, matte varnish on the whole model, but I've glossed up the lenses, the optical bits. You can see on this one, he says he hopes, shine some light, that'll help. So yeah, you can see there's a little bit of a reflectiveness to the blue lens, so that's done to all of it, all the lenses around it. And I do like it. I think it's come out really nicely. I'm hoping to use this next weekend at Brian, Temporal Crusade 01's, as we're doing a big APOC battle. Not next weekend, sorry, in a fortnight. So I shall be using this. I did build, as some of you know, Land Raider Achilles, painted it up. It wasn't in the rules at the time, but unfortunately I wasn't allowed it. Not now anyway. So I've had to do this and get this up and running, just so we can get the battle to look as right as possible. Anyway, please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Take care.